Hello everyone, I've got another maths trolling video for you today. It's going to be slightly different to the maths trolling video by Minute Physics, because it's going to be a different trick, and the maths is going to be a little bit more hardcore, but we'll cope. I'm going to start with something quite simple. I'm going to take the sum of alternating fractions. So it's going to be 1 minus a half plus a third minus a quarter plus a fifth minus a sixth plus, and you do that forever. So I'm going to call that sum of alternating fractions S. Now we're going to try and work out the value of S. I already know what the value of S is, but I'm not going to tell you straight away. I'll save that. Let's use this series to work out the value of S. Now we're not just going to add it term by term, that's not going to work. So I'm going to rearrange the terms first. So I'm going to take that series, I'm going to rearrange the terms so it looks like this, and hopefully you can see that that's exactly the same thing. All the terms are there, I've just rearranged them. Now I've bracketed them in a special way, so if you can see in the first bracket I've got 1 minus a half, so I'm going to simplify that down to a half. In the second bracket I've got a third minus a sixth, so I'll just simplify that down so it's a sixth, which is true. And then in the third bracket you can see I've got a fifth minus a tenth, so I'll simplify that to a tenth, and you'll do that forever. Now you might notice that all the fractions are even. So I'm going to take out a factor of a half. I'm allowed to do that. So I'll take out a factor of a half, and what I get is another sum of alternating fractions again. So that's my original series again, that's S. So what I've got is S is equal to a half S, which is fine if S is equal to zero. So S must be equal to zero. Solved. The problem is I already knew what the sum was equal to. That alternating sum of fractions is actually equal to the natural log of 2. If you're not familiar with the natural log of 2, don't worry, that's equal to 0.693 and it's not equal to zero. Now that formula for the natural log of 2 is correct. I'm telling you that is 0.693. So what's gone wrong? So this sum of alternating fractions is actually a convergent series, and it's converging to the log of 2. If you're interested in why it's converging to the log of 2, there's actually a formula for natural logs, which I'll put in the description. But it's converging to a value. So it's actually a special type of convergent series. It's called a conditionally convergent series. The idea is, these are series that converge, but they have positive and negative terms. And if you turn the negative terms into positive terms, the series doesn't converge anymore. So in our example, we had this sum of alternating fractions. If we turn all the negative fractions into positive fractions, then you just get a sum of fractions. And that's actually very slowly diverging off to infinity. So it's one of these special types of series. Now these special series have a theorem. It's called Riemann Series Theorem. And the idea of the theorem is that you can rearrange the terms of these series and you can make them equal anything that you want, which is actually quite amazing when you think about it. You can pick a value, you can rearrange the terms, and you can make these series equal anything that you choose. So the idea is, the trick is, you sort of zigzag towards the value you've picked. In our example, I was zigzagging towards half log 2, which is 0.346. So what you do is you add some positive terms, so you sort of go over the value you've picked, 0.346. Then you take away some negative terms, so you go below the value. Then you add some more positive terms, so you go a bit above. Then you take some negative terms, so you go a bit below. Then add some positive terms, you go a bit above. And you're very slowly zigzagging closer and closer to the value you've picked. You can always do that for these special types of series. And this idea of zigzagging closer and closer to your value is exactly the definition of a convergent series. So you can rearrange the terms and you can make them converge to anything you've picked, which I do think is quite amazing. Now, this is a different trick to that maths trolling video done by Minute Physics. When I saw that video, I saw some comments underneath the video that said, oh, the solution to this is that it's an application of Riemann's series theorem, which sounds very clever, but it's wrong. And I saw that and I thought, ah, someone on the internet is wrong. I must correct them. So I've done that now. My work here is done. And if you have been, thanks for watching.